Plenty of us joke that we dance with two left feet.
Quick.
If you're JoAnne Fluke of Abilene, Texas,
I'm like, I'm back on my home turf.
You don't even need to be able to stand.
Can I turn you?
To shine on the dance floor.
That's what the dance floor is to me, like that's home.
Not what you'd expect to hear from someone with half a body. Fluke has caudal regression syndrome, a rare birth defect that left her with legs webbed at the knee.
Literally, when I was born, the doctors said I was one in a million, and they only gave me 72 hours to live.
43 years later, she continues to defy all expectations as a professional ballroom dancer and Zumba instructor, motivating others at this adaptive recreation clinic in Dallas to see the possibilities.
I think that that's actually my gift from God, is my disability. Because if I didn't have my disability, I wouldn't have the opportunity to help others who have those same challenges.
I feel like a lot of times we as able-bodied people think that people who are in a wheelchair can't do all the things that we do. It depends on the person.
Kellen Wiegand and her fellow Master of Prosthetics-Orthotics classmates with UT Southwestern School of Health Professions organized this event in partnership with OPAF, the Orthotic and Prosthetic Activities Foundation.
I think we're really just helping do what should be done, right? So people shouldn't see people with disabilities as different or less than.
At school, these learners are becoming skilled at creating custom prostheses and fitting them on volunteer patients.
I want to be hands-on with them and talk to them, get to know them.
In the community, students like Crystal Lee Polk continue helping those without limbs overcome obstacles and fears.
For us, we've all been involved in sports, and to be able to give that aspect of life back to that patient population was really special for us.
I see our stories as coming together to form a bigger picture. A picture of support, a picture of love, a picture of community that can help people through some of the darkest times in their lives.
Darren Ray was hit head-on by a drunk driver going 30 miles over the speed limit in 2006. His legs were crushed.
I was going to school, I was going to seminary, study to be a minister, and everything came to a halt.
He credits the cheerleaders in his life for motivating him to achieve his dream of becoming an ordained minister.
Gotcha.
And to once again enjoy the simple joys of getting back on a tennis court.
It feels wonderful to pick up the racket. It's like riding a bicycle. It just kind of comes back to you.
Proof that internal strength is far greater than any outward disability.
Limb loss doesn't mean life loss. Because of the help of students like this, limb loss can still mean life gain.
And judging by this group, they have a lot of life to live.